welcome to Ice Monkey Tech. I'm Stephen, and once again, another video, 2 in 1 week. I am spoiling you by the looks of it. It would seem so anyway. Anyway, as promised, I'm doing a benchmark video on the £500 PC I built, or the £500 budget PC I built, which actually came in at £501.93. However, I did have to pay £5 for delivery on all the stock, which you must take into consideration because it's still within your budget. And also, I paid an extra £20 for a CPU cooler, which I didn't really need to because we did get one with the i3 processor, but I didn't want to use it. I suppose it would have done the job, but not as good as this one does. Anyway, I haven't gone all out with temperatures and stuff like that. I have been keeping an eye on the temperatures. The temperature's been sitting around the mid-60s on the graphics card and under 50 degrees on the CPU, which I'm extremely pleased with. So plenty of airflow in this case, which is a good thing. And I didn't go all out on brand new titles. I thought I'd have a little array of titles that would give us an idea of how good the machine actually was. I'm very, very pleased with this graphics card, as you'll find out now, as I shall run some benchmarks. Here you go. What do you get with an i3, 5500XT and 16GB of RAM? Well, that's what you get. I do think the 16GB of RAM makes a difference from 8GB of RAM. Gives the machine a little bit more punch. You'll get a good few more frames per second out of it. And even Rise of the Tomb Raider, 83 frames per second on Ultra. And I've got about 213 frames per second on F1 2018. I don't expect that to change much between that and 2020. You may hit down to around about 100 frames per second. Metro Last Light, 93 frames per second. That was on high settings. Metro Exodus, this is the one that surprised us. In high settings, I was getting about 44 frames per second. Probably get a little bit laggy here, especially when the screen gets full. You're probably going to struggle. However, if you drop it down to medium settings, 57 frames per second on average. Sometimes it was getting over 100, sometimes it was hitting below. But it still looks great in medium settings. There's no reason why you can't play this game with this card. It's absolutely great. And then we'll go to Star Wars Fallen Jedi. Yet again, 85.4 frames per second. Excellent, because this game looks beautiful and it plays great. If you haven't tried this one and you like the Tomb Raider style games, play this one. It's absolutely fantastic. And I didn't want to add this, but I thought I'd better put it in. Fortnite, 120 frames per second on Epic settings, right the way through. I'm sure if you drop a few seconds down in settings down and you want more frames per second, you can get them out of it, but perfectly playable. Thought I'd better chuck that one in because everybody seems to want to chuck that one in. Now, my thoughts at the end of the day. If you're looking for an entry system, there's no reason why something like this won't do you. You don't need to spend a fortune to game in high quality, especially if you're just starting out 1080p. Forget about all this 4K at £500. You're never going to get 4K at £500. In theory, if I pay £200 for a graphics card and it lasts me a year or two, then I have to pay another £200 for a graphics card. In 4 years, I've paid £400 for a graphics card that has kept me up to date for 4 years. Not £1,000 for a graphics card that I'm going to change in 2 years because there's another new one comes out and I've got to have that. So it just stands to reason. Entry level system, absolutely fantastic. And the machine looks great as well. That's the other thing. Just because it's £500 doesn't mean it doesn't have to look good. So there we go. Hopefully give you some insight into the fact that you do not have to spend an absolute fortune to get into PC gaming. And I think that's all we've got to say on that one. Have a fantastic Christmas and I'll see you in the new year. Take care and goodbye for now.